Hi guys, it's Denma and welcome to the Wolf's Den. Today I'm going to be reacting to Say Amen by Panic at the Disco. I watched This Is Gospel in Emperor's New Clothes, so now I'm caught up on the storyline, so we have to see where this fits into it. Okay, so we got a news broadcast. Ancient artifact, Devil's Key, is stolen from the museum. So is this after he turned into, like, a devil or a demon? Like, does this key help him become human, or at least look like a human, or whatever? Looks like there's, looks like a birthday dinner. Yeah, birthday, happy birthday, baby. Set out. And all these bad guys are coming in. That's a big speaker in that wall. I don't know what to expect. Noisy trucks. I'm sorry for the traffic, guys. Okay, so he is human again, or he has the necklace. I can see it around his neck. Yep, there it is. So I guess it gives him the power to look human or become human again. Okay, why is he being so cocky now? I mean, okay, there's the music. Something's about to go down. Okay, that's not what I was expecting. You better do a few more amens than that, bro. Okay, so he has superhuman strength. So, how many dudes are in, like, trying to get this necklace? Jesus. No pun intended, because that's the devil's neck, some whatever it was. Oh shit, here comes the big speaker. No, don't. Ew, it's so gory. What did you do, take some lessons from, like, Mike Weston and Bernardes? Jesus Christ. Dude, I thought it was Bella Thorne at first. She's been in everything here lately. Okay, that was not cool. You just don't do that. But he's now in the clothes that he wore, and This Is Gospel. So is this a prequel? Really? You kicked him in the nuts. Now you gotta hit him with a bat? But he didn't have the blood spatter in This Is Gospel, but he's in the same black pants, sneakers, and white shirt. Now he doesn't have the necklace, so. And then you hear the sirens, so that makes me think, okay, they're taking him to the doctor. I think this was meant to be like a prequel to those two videos? I have no idea. I'm sorry, I'm balling my hands up in my sweater because I've got the fan on to kind of tune out the sound in the living room, and it's cold. But yeah, that was a very gory video. Not what I was expecting. It was very good. I'm gonna have to listen to the song a couple of times to, like, get into the song, because there was so much going on in the video. You couldn't really listen to the lyrics of the song. I mean, it was a catchy beat and stuff like that, but, like, I wasn't really paying attention to the lyrics because I wanted to hear, like, or see what was going on in the video. And wow. Let's just say this. Brandon Urie and Panic at the Disco has come back in vengeance, and I will probably be picking up this album, and I hope all the songs are like this, or all the videos are like this. They tell a story, because I like that aspect of music videos. They aren't just, like, people standing around showing off all their money. Like, the beat I really liked, and the beat down he gave those guys, which was pretty awesome if I say to it myself. So what are your thoughts on this video? Is it a prequel, sequel, what? To the other two videos. Where do you think it falls in the timeline? So, if there's a video you want me to react to or whatever, suggest it down below, and I will
if I pick yours, I will give you a shout out. Like, comment, subscribe, join the pack, you know, all that good stuff. And I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys.